Hello, you're on Public Spot. I'm George. Welcome to a new series where I explore the different levels, layers, and ways of handling web requests through reverse proxy. I'll start from the simplest setup and look into web request forwarding using Nginx on my local machine. And so if this series and the content of this channel lines up with your interests, hit the subscribe button and join me in this journey of learning by doing. So, let's start coding. Most of the things that I'll be doing today will involve setting up and running Docker containers. I'll be using a containerized version of Nginx as web proxy to filter and control access to my web applications. So I'll start with my terminal session and create a new directory for today's episode. And then I'm going to cd into this new directory and then initialize my git. I'm going to rename my default branch from master to main, and then open my VS Code on this directory and start the work. In the root of this local repository, I'll create my Docker Compose file. I'm going to set up a blogging application using a Docker image called Ghost. This Docker image uses port 2368, so I'm going to expose this port. I'm also going to set up another web application used for TV series collection management called Sonar. This Docker image is configured to run on port 8989, so I'm also going to expose that port. The next application I'm going to set up is a movie collection manager called Radar. This Docker image is configured to run on port 7878, so I'm going to expose this port locally as well. And lastly, I'm going to configure my Nginx web proxy. Port 80 is used in this application by default, so I'll open this port. Now I'm going to save my changes and then open my terminal and run Docker Compose up to start all my web applications. Docker Compose appears to have completed bringing my web applications up. So I'll switch to my browser and verify that all my applications are accessible. I'll start by verifying my blog application on port 2368. So that's loading fine. Now I'm going to check my Sonar application on port 8989. So my Sonar application is also loading fine. Next one is my Radar app. I'm going to check if my Radar application is loading on port 7878. So that's also looking fine. And then lastly, my default Nginx on port 80. All my web applications are working fine. Keep in mind that what I've done to verify that my web applications are working is directly accessing the web applications on the actual ports they are running on. So this is not normally how web apps are meant to be set up. This is because it is exposing the web applications from direct access and very, very vulnerable to denial of service threats. So what I need to do is set up some kind of a trapdoor, or technically called web proxy. And all web requests to my system will pass through this proxy, which will then control the way the requests are routed to my web applications. So this is where Nginx comes into play. Let me switch back to my VS Code. If I go ahead and remove the ports property of my blog application, save my changes, and restart Docker Compose. Now if I switch back to my browser and access the blog application on port 2368, which is the first tab, the page is not loading properly. This is because I have disabled direct access to the web application. I'm going to switch back to my VS Code to set up my proxy to make my blog application accessible. The first thing I'll do is create a custom Nginx configuration file. Before I proceed, please note that these config settings are very basic. It is the simplest way to illustrate very high-level web routing mechanism of Nginx. I will set up a routing block to forward port 8080 on my machine via Nginx. I need this port forwarding to be relegated to my blog application, so I'll add this block. In my Docker Compose file, I have set up the service name to Ghost for my blog application, which explains why my proxy path is set this way. Now, I need to load this configuration file inside my Nginx container. And so in my Docker Compose file, I'll update my Nginx block and add a volume map. The volumes property that I've just set up will map my custom Nginx configuration file to the appropriate location inside my Nginx container. And because I'm forwarding requests on port 8080 on my Nginx container, I need to open up this port. So I'm going to update ports property for my Nginx service. Now let me open my terminal and then restart my Docker Compose. And then switch to my browser to verify my changes. If I refresh this page and try to access my blog application on port 2368, the page still does not load. But if I try to access it via my Nginx web proxy on port 8080, now I can access my blog application. Let me switch back to my VS Code and implement port forwarding for the other two web applications. For a start, I'm going to remove the port property on both my Sonar and Radar web apps that exposes the internal ports where both applications are running. And in my custom Nginx configuration, I'll forward requests going through port 8081 to my Sonar application. So in here, I'm going to introduce a new routing block for port 8081. In my Docker Compose file, I set the service name for this web app to Sonar, and so I'll set up the proxy pass property to point to this service name and the internal port where the app is running. I also need to add port forwarding block for my Radar app. So I'll forward the request coming through port 8082 to this application. And also in my Docker Compose file, I set the service name for this web app to Radar. And so I'll set up the proxy pass property to point to this service using the internal port where the application is running. I have set both my web applications accessible on ports 8081 and 8082 via my Nginx container. So I need to update my Docker Compose file and expose these ports on my Nginx container. So I'm going to go back to my Docker Compose file. Now I'm going to save all my changes. Open my terminal. And then restart my Docker Compose. And then I'm going to switch to my browser and verify my changes. I'll verify my Sonar web application first. I'm going to check if it can be accessed directly via port 8989. And the page does not load. Now if I try to access it via my Nginx web proxy on port 8081, the page loads properly. Now let me verify my Radar application and check if it's accessible directly via port 7878. The page also does not load. And if I try to access it via my Nginx web proxy on port 8082, the page loads properly. This means that all my port forwarding configurations are working. So let me switch back to my VS Code and set up another way of request forwarding. On my custom Nginx config file, I will update the port forwarding settings for port 8080 right here. I will add routing rules based on path, and I want these existing settings to route requests based on the path in the URI. So I'll update this existing setting to only route requests that have ghost in the URI. I will add another rule to forward all other requests to my default Nginx application. And I will set the proxy pass property to the appropriate Nginx service and the port where the application is running. Now I'm going to open my terminal and restart my Docker Compose. And now I'm going to switch to my browser to verify all my changes. If I access my blog application on port 8080, this takes me to the default Nginx application. However, if I add ghost in the URL, it takes me to my blogging application page. That's it for today. Next time, I'll set this up in the cloud and explore application load balancer in AWS. In the meantime, let me know your thoughts in the comments below and send me some likes if you find this useful. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you like my content and help me spread the word about this channel. Until next time, keep learning and stay safe.